Okay, everyone listen now. This is the second unit of your unit 1 introduction to AI, and one more sub unit is left after that session. So this is about the second sub unit, basics of AI. Let's get started. And I am covering the first part of this, that is introduction of AI and related terminologies. What are these three terminologies? AI, ML and DL. But I cannot cover this second part in this video. I will cover this part in second video. Okay. So now this is all about these three different terminologies of AI. AI, ML, DL and their differentiation. So basics of AI, the first part. Three terminologies of AI, AI, ML and DL. So first, what is artificial intelligence has always been a term which introduced people all over the world. Means everyone is so curious about artificial intelligence, and everyone who knows something about AI is also creating the curiosity about this term all over the world. Everyone want to know, everyone want to create curiosity for this term, and various organizations have coined this own versions of defining artificial intelligence. A number of definitions of artificial intelligence are available online, and different organizations have coined their definition, but we cannot say that there is any standard definition of AI exists. Everyone can define AI in their own terms, in their own thought process and their area of application. So I am sharing few of the definition which is given in your manual as well. So first is by Niti Aayog. Niti Aayog has published National Strategy for Artificial Intelligence, and in this book it is written that AI refers to the ability of machines to perform cognitive tasks. AI refers to the ability of machines to perform cognitive tasks. What are the cognitive tasks? Cognitive tasks like thinking, perceiving, learning, problem solving, decision making. Means whatever task which is directly related to our brain. So all these cognitive tasks, if any technology which make a machine able to perform these cognitive tasks, then that machine will be AI enabled, and that term known as AI. So Niti Aayog defined AI as, AI refers to the ability of machine to perform cognitive tasks like thinking, perceiving, learning, problem solving and decision making. So one more definition you will get in the next slides. That AI is the technology which enable a machine, or which make a machine able to mimic human intelligence. Then these two lines you can write for definition of AI. So this is very good definition of AI coined by Niti Aayog. So you can use this whenever you are writing the answer of definition of AI. Few more things, few more points was mentioned by Niti Aayog in their book, in its book. So it should also be known. Initially conceived as technology that could mimic human intelligence, AI has evolved in the way that far exceeds its original conception. In the beginning of AI development, everyone know that AI is a technology which mimic human intelligence. In short, we say that AI is a technology which mimic human intelligence, but now it is beyond that because it is developed a lot. So this original conception is now far exceed. That's why we cannot say that AI is the technology which mimic human intelligence only. That's why you have to mention two points. First, you can say that AI is the technology that mimic human intelligence, and this term refers to the ability of machines to perform cognitive tasks like this. So I suggest you write both the lines. The next point, with incredible advances made in data collection, processing and computation power, intelligent system means AI enabled systems can now be deployed to take over the variety of tasks, enable productivity and enhance productivity. Means when AI is enabled, means AI machines based on data training, means jitni aap training kara rahe ho machine ki, usi ke base pe AI work kar raha hai. So as we have advancement in data collection, in data processing, in computation power of the machine, the AI is developed incredible way. So this is the power. This is the main development because of which intelligent system can now be deployed to take over the variety of tasks. Now, intelligent system can work with AI technology and it enable connectivity and enhance productivity of their system. So, this is not much important, but you should know the definitions of this organization coined by these organization. Now, the second one is World Economic Forum. This is the another organization which defined AI. AI is the software engine that drives the fourth industrial revolution. Many of the students saying that this is the wrong definition, but it is not, because they have written this definition in their perspective. So we cannot say that is the wrong definition. Software means any idea, any technology, any thought, you can say it software. So artificial intelligence, the software engine, means the power, means the thought, means the idea that drives the fourth industrial revolution. Why we are writing that it drives the fourth industrial revolution? Because before fourth industrial revolution, what is fourth industrial revolution? Before the starting to talk about fourth industrial revolution, I want to remind you the three industrial revolution. In the world, there were three industrial revolution. The first industrial revolution was powered by water and steam. Means all the industries working, existing in that period was powered by water and steam. And after that, the second industrial revolution came in existence after the development of electricity. And industries were powered by electricity. And the third industrial revolution based on the power of IT, computer, digital world with electricity. So that was the three industrial revolution. Now the fourth industrial revolution in which we are existing, this will be driven by AI technology. So AI is the software engine that drives the fourth industrial revolution. So this definition is coined by World Economic Forum. World Economic Forum has given few more important points about AI. Its impact can already be seen in homes, business, political processes, and also in many more areas. AI's impact can already be seen in these areas. In its embodied form means if we are saying that AI get a shape of robot, a humanoid, or any structured human-like structure, then we can say body, then it is embodied form of AI, embodied form of robots. So in its embodied form of robots, it will soon be driving cars, talking warehouses, and caring for the young and elderly. And I mean, you can see that they are teaching in classes, they are taking care of patients in hospitals and giving nursing, and reading news readers are, reporters are there. So now in embodied form, it is working just like human. Third point, it holds the promise of solving some of the most promising issues facing society. Yes, AI holds the promise of solving some of the most promising issues. Bahut sari problem jo society mein exist kar rahi hain, jinko solve karna bahut mushkil tha. Yes, AI make them possible. But also presents challenges. What challenges? Such as incredible black box, algorithm, unethical use of data, and potential job displacement. AI ने जहाँ हमें power दी है हमारी problem solution का जो अभी तक नहीं हो पा रही थी, but it also presents challenges. कैसे challenges? Incredible black box. We know that AI, the deep जहाँ आप कहते हो ना एक एडवांस फॉर्म ऑफ एआई है, जो डीप लर्निंग पे बेस्ड है, उसमें इन द न्यूरल नेटवर्क वर्क्स, एंड इन न्यूरल नेटवर्क देयर इज अ हिडन लेयर वेयर द होल एल्गोरिदम वर्क दैट इज अ ब्लैक बॉक्स. मींस हिडन लेयर इज नॉट विजिबल टू एनीवन, इवन द क्रिएटर ऑफ दैट मॉडल, दैट एआई मॉडल. सो इट इज ब्लैक बॉक्स, और यू कैन से इट इज अ मैजिक बॉक्स, एंड इट इज इनस्क्रूटेबल. नोबडी कैन सी व्हाट इज हैपनिंग इनसाइड. सो दिस कैन बी रिस्क and unethical use of data. And yes, if AI is working data, then that data can be used unethically, and the potential job displacement. Yes, if AI is working in many areas where human are working, and now AI can replace their jobs. So potential job displacement is also a risk. So if we are solving problems with AI, we are also facing challenges due to AI. The next organization, one more point. As rapid of daily life and as the technology itself can learn and change on its own, multi-stakeholder collaboration is required to optimize accountability, transparency, privacy and impartiality to create trust. जो problems हम face कर रहे हैं उसका solution कौन निकालेगा AI की वजह से जो challenges आ रहे हैं? Yes, उसमें क्या है? The technology itself can learn. AI technology अपने आप learn कर रहा है. Learn with experience and improve. Change हो रहा है. On its own. So, अगर किसी ने कोई AI model, AI machine create की है, we can't say that it will work in the same way in future forever. We can't say. It can change because it is learning continuously. So, it can, the responsibility of its working cannot be claimed on any one person. So multi-stakeholder collaboration is required to optimize accountability. Nobody can take the responsibility of that machine. जैसे हम कहते हैं self-driving car आपने purchase कर ली और अगर कोई accident होता है तो हम कहते हैं कि this is the responsibility of the company which is producing these cars. Or you can say that this is the accountability of the owner of the car. But no, it requires multi-stakeholder collaboration to optimize accountability. Everyone need to use that technology responsibly. कोई किसी को claim नहीं कर सकता कि ये आपकी वजह से हुआ, आपने इसको गलत create किया, आपने इसको गलत person कुछ भी, आप इसको किसी एक person की accountability नहीं हो सकती. Transparency, whatever is going on in this machine, आप इसमें क्या changes कर रहे हो, उसकी transparency होनी चाहिए, privacy होनी चाहिए, data आप जो इसमें provide कर रहे हो training के लिए, testing के लिए, उसकी privacy होनी चाहिए, impartial होना चाहिए, bias नहीं होना चाहिए. After all these type of multi-stakeholder collaboration, we can use this technology fruitfully. The another organization, European Artificial Leadership. Exactly the name of the book, name of the published material, The Path for an Integrated Vision. This is the whole name of the book. So this coined the definition as AI is not a well-defined technology, yes, and no universally agreed definition exists. This is the first point. It is rather a cover term for techniques associated with data analysis and pattern recognition. उन्होंने simply ये कह दिया कि AI की तो कोई well-known technology है नहीं, इसका कोई universally agreed definition नहीं है. It is just the term जो cover करता है उन सारी techniques को जो associated हैं with data analysis and pattern recognition. Means आप data analyze करके जो result देने का एक technology, जैसे आप Google search पे करते हो या आपके likes dislikes पे आपको जो मिलते रहते हैं suggestions, और pattern recognition जैसे हम pattern recognize करके अगर कुछ technology के through create कर रहे हैं, तो with data analysis and pattern recognition technologies associated with these two type of things all covered in the term AI. This is definition coined by European Artificial Intelligence Leadership. They also said that AI is not a new technology having existed since 1950s. Yes, it is very old, but still it is in the developing phase. While some market sectors and individual businesses are more advanced than others, AI is still a relatively early age of development. 1950s se iska development start hua, still it is in the stage of early development, early stage of development. और उस 1950s में और बहुत सारे जो भी बिजनेस सेक्टर मार्केट में डेवलपमेंट हुए थे वो आज फार एडवांस्ड हैं, लेकिन एआई इज स्टिल इन अर्ली एज ऑफ डेवलपमेंट. सो दैट द रेंज ऑफ पोटेंशियल एप्लीकेशंस एंड द क्वालिटी ऑफ मोस्ट एग्जिस्टिंग एप्लीकेशंस हैव एम्पल मार्जिन लेफ्ट फॉर फर्दर डेवलपमेंट एंड इम्प्रूवमेंट. क्योंकि इस एआई में जो पोटेंशियल एप्लीकेशंस कवर होते हैं, रेंज ऑफ पोटेंशियल एप्लीकेशंस कवर होते हैं और उनकी क्वालिटी है जो एग्जिस्टिंग एप्लीकेशन की, उसमें अभी भी बहुत मार्जिन है कि हम उसको और बेटर कर सकते हैं. एम्पल अपॉर्चुनिटी फॉर इट्स बेटरमेंट. दैट्स व्हाई स्टिल एआई इज इन अर्ली एज ऑफ डेवलपमेंट. नाउ द लास्ट वन, द अकॉर्डिंग टू इंसाइक्लोपीडिया ब्रिटानिका, एवरीवन नो द नेम ऑफ द बुक. Encyclopedia Britannica coined the definition of AI as artificial intelligence is the ability of a digital computer or computer control robot to perform tasks commonly associated with intelligent beings. Simple definition. कि ये common एक definition है, किसी के भी लिए ये समझने के लिए more than enough है कि क्या है जिससे intelligent being का associated है, वो technology है ये. कि आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस डिजिटल कंप्यूटर या कंप्यूटर कंट्रोल किसी भी रोबोट या डिवाइस में एक एबिलिटी क्रिएट करता है. किस चीज की एबिलिटी? टू परफॉर्म टास्क. कौन से टास्क? कॉमनली एसोसिएट विद इंटेलिजेंट बीइंग. वो सारे टास्क जो पहले सिर्फ इंटेलिजेंट बीइंग्स या इंटेलिजेंट पर्सन ही कर सकते थे, उनको करने की एबिलिटी अगर रोबोट या मशीन को दे दी गई, देन दैट एबिलिटी इज नोन एज AI. दिस इज द डेफिनेशन कॉइंड बाय Encyclopedia Britannica. The term is frequently applied to the project of developing systems endowed with the intellectual processes characteristic of humans, such as the ability to reason, discover meaning, generalize or learn from past experience. तो सिंबल उसको थोड़ा सा और एक्सप्लेन किया है. पॉइंट वही है कि वो सारी चीजें जो ह्यूमन की थी एग्जैक्टली, एबिलिटी टू रीजन, रीजनिंग एबिलिटी, डिस्कवरिंग, जनरलाइजिंग एंड लर्निंग विद पास्ट एक्सपीरियंस, ऑल दीज एबिलिटी विल बी डेवलप विल बी एम्बेडेड इन मशीन बाई AI टेक्नोलॉजी, एंड दैट टेक्नोलॉजी इज टर्म्ड एज AI. ओके, नाउ आफ्टर डिस्कसिंग दीज definition, we can define AI as, still it is not proper definition, but AI is a form of intelligence, a type of technology and a field of study. Because we know AI, the term can be defined in any different terms. Means आप AI को technological terms में भी define कर सकते हो. एक इंटेलिजेंस के टर्म में अगर आप एक एजुकेशन सिस्टम के अकॉर्डिंग सोचें, एक सब्जेक्ट के हिसाब से सोचें, तो आप वो भी डिफाइन कर सकते हैं. और AI खुद एक फील्ड ऑफ स्टडी है, तो इसकी डिफरेंट फॉर्म्स हैं. दैट्स व्हाई वी आर सेइंग दैट AI इज अ फॉर्म ऑफ इंटेलिजेंस, यस इट इज अ टाइप ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी, यस एंड इट इज ऑल्सो अ फील्ड ऑफ स्टडी. तो इन तीनों ही एरिया में AI की स्टडी हो रही है और हम उसे डील कर रहे हैं. AI theory and development of computer system, both machines and software, enables machines to perform tasks that normally require human intelligence. AI theory and development of computer system in terms of machines and software. तो AI की जितनी भी theories और development हम कह रहे हैं, वो enable कर रही है, चाहे आप software के terms में कहो, चाहे आप hardware के terms में कहो, that enables machine to perform tasks. वो machine को उन टास्क को इनेबल करने के लिए इनेबल कर रही है जो नॉर्मली ह्यूमन इंटेलिजेंस से ही पॉसिबल थे. सो दिस इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ AI अकॉर्डिंग टू योर मैनुअल. आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस कवर्स अ ब्रॉड रेंज ऑफ डोमेन्स एंड एप्लीकेशन एंड इज एक्सपेक्टेड टू इंपैक्ट एवरी फील्ड इन द फ्यूचर. AI बहुत अलग अलग एरियाज में वर्क कर रहा है. अगर हम इमेजेस वीडियोज के कंप्यूटर विजन एक डोमेन है जिसमें हम इमेजेस से काम करते हैं, वीडियोस से काम करके हम कुछ टेक्नोलॉजी क्रिएट कर रहे हैं. इन डेटा साइंसेज मीन्स आप डेटा के स्टैटिस्टिकल डेटा के थ्रू कुछ मतलब डिस्कवर करते हैं कुछ इंफॉर्मेशन, उसकी यूज करके आप एक कुछ अपना मॉडल बनाते हो, मशीन बनाते हो. और यू कैन यूज द लैंग्वेज एंड टेक्सुअल इंफॉर्मेशन और द ऑडियो इंफॉर्मेशन. दैट एरिया इज नोन एज NLP. In this language section, you are having another domain, NLP. So AI covers a broad range of domains and application and is expected to impact every field in the future. कि अभी भी ये सोचते हैं कि इन थ्री डोमेन्स को हमने देखा है, लेकिन इन फ्यूचर इट विल कवर एवरी फील्ड. ओवरऑल इट्स कोर आइडिया इज बिल्डिंग मशीन्स एंड एल्गोरिदम्स विच आर केपेबल ऑफ परफॉर्मिंग कंप्यूटेशनल टास्क दैट वुड अदरवाइज रिक्वायर ह्यूमन लाइक ब्रेन फंक्शंस. तो ओवरऑल वो उसको कर रहा क्या है, उस ओवरऑल आप AI के थ्रू मशीन से एल्गोरिदम बना रहे हो विच इज कैपेबल ऑफ परफॉर्मिंग कंप्यूटेशनल टास्क विच नीड ह्यूमन इंटेलिजेंस. आप ह्यूमन ब्रेन के थ्रू जो कंप्यूटेशनल टास्क कर सकते थे, अब वो हम मशीन से करा रहे हैं थ्रू AI टेक्नोलॉजी. दिस इज द कोर आइडिया. नाउ दीज आर दी थ्री डिफरेंट टर्म्स वी आर यूजिंग इन AI. AI, ML, DL, जिसमें लोग कंफ्यूज होते हैं एंड इसमें क्लियर डिफरेंशिएशन समझ में नहीं आता है किसी को, तो आई एम ट्राइंग टू क्लियर इट हियर. AI इज द इंजीनियरिंग ऑफ मेकिंग इंटेलिजेंट मशीन एंड प्रोग्राम. सिंपल, दिस इज द टू मेकिंग इंटेलिजेंट मशीन्स एंड प्रोग्राम. Second, ML. ML is the ability to learn without any explicitly programmed model. Means AI में जरूरी नहीं, AI में आप algorithm create कर सकते हैं, जरूरी नहीं है कि without programming एक work करें. जैसे आप scripted chatbot हैं तो वो भी AI की category में आते हैं, क्योंकि आप उस ऐसा नहीं है कि AI जो terminology है वो खाली मशीन लर्निंग पे ही बेस है. नहीं, स्क्रिप्टेड चैटबॉट भी आपके एआई में आते हैं. बट मशीन लर्निंग अगर हम कह रहे हैं, देन इट विल बी द एबिलिटी ऑफ द मशीन टू लर्न विदाउट एनी एक्सप्लिसिटली प्रोग्राम एआई मॉडल. वहां पे कोई मॉडलिंग नहीं होगी, सॉरी वहां पे कोई प्रोग्रामिंग नहीं होगी. वो न्यूरल नेटवर्क पे बेस्ड होते हैं और उसमें कोई प्रोग्रामिंग नहीं होती है. मशीन विल डेवलप इट्स एल्गोरिदम इटसेल्फ ऑन द ट्रेनिंग ऑफ डेटा. डेटा ट्रेन के थ्रू ट्रेन करते हैं मशीन को, मशीन उनको एनालाइज करके अपना एल्गोरिदम खुद क्रिएट करती है. तो ML लर्न विदाउट एनी प्रोग्राम एंड वर्क विदाउट एनी एल्गोरिदम. इट क्रिएट्स इट्स ओन एल्गोरिदम ऑन डेटा ट्रेनिंग, पर वो हम जो क्रिएटर है वो उसको कोई एल्गोरिदम नहीं देता. In deep learning learns learning based on deep neural network. Yes, deep learning model will be also based on neural network, but deep neural network. It means that the machine will learn with data training, but that data that learning will go on and it can do mistakes and it can get reward according to its correct and wrong suggestion, wrong answers, and with that mistakes and with that correct answer, that rewards, it will learn day by day and it will improve day by day, and this way it is the best type of AI model which can work better in future. But if you are saying that that scripted chatbot type of model which is based on only AI, that will not improve. But this deep learning type of AI model will improve day by day and on the basis of correct and wrong answers working, it will be rewarded or punished, and that way it will work better and better in future. So this is the deep learning model. Now you can see the video to understand the term better, because this video will show you the example. This video is created and published by Simply Learn. Simply Learn. Okay, now watch the video.
There's something that look like people, and it programs that so that when the black and white image comes in, it goes, okay, that piece right there resembles this and all these other photos. And the neural network is able to identify that and then color the beach ball with the colors that you see on there. So it gives it a full. This is really wonderful because they did a wonderful job coloring this picture. And that's the full.
Sorry, I have to start it again because it is not from the starting point. Wait a minute. Yes, now you can see.
Simply Learn welcomes you to machine learning versus deep learning versus artificial intelligence. Some of the most exciting technologies evolving in today's world. My name is Richard Kirshner, and I'll be hosting this talk for Simply Learn. Before we start covering the basics of these three topics and how they connect and how they are different, let's just look at a few examples so we get an understanding of what's going on. Here's an example of artificial intelligence in today's world, Amazon Echo. Amazon Echo is a wonderful tool. We can go in there and you can say, hey, Alexa, what's the temperature in Chicago? And the Amazon Echo then translates that into zeros and ones and something the computer understands. Then it comes in and processes that information to identify what you're asking and what you need and where to get that information. And then it comes back and says, the current temperature in Chicago is 6 degrees Fahrenheit or whatever it is at the moment. So this is a wonderful example of artificial intelligence that we're using right now today and where that's at as far as a commercial deployment. Machine learning. Machine learning example out there.
The example of AI which is shown just here is the example of that voice assistant. So many of the voice assistants are based on AI technology only, in which you are putting your question and they will give the answer. So this is the example of Alexa, no? So this is the example of AI technology.
There is Google. You're on your Google search engine. It comes up. You spend a lot of time on the first link you come into and you read the page. And Google looks at that and says, okay, he spent 5 minutes on this. Let's give it a thumbs up. And then you go to the second page and the third page. You just kind of skip over them and glance at them for a couple seconds. And Google says, I wasn't interested in those pages. Let's give them a thumbs down. So this is a good example of machine learning as it starts guessing what you like and what you don't like. So it gives you more information along what you're going to read and actually use. And then we have an example of deep learning.
And the Google search is the example of ML, machine learning, where when you will search any information on Google, when you purchase anything on any commercial website, or whenever you are listening any song or music in any of such platform, in social media platform, then the application or the online portal will register, will keep the record of your likes, dislike, your search and your interest, and according to that analysis it will give you the suggestion. So this is machine learning platform, because there it takes the data and train the machine on that data. So this is ML example, and now this is deep learning example given in this video.
In this example we have a black and white image. It comes into, in this case, a neural network. Some people like to call it a magic box, because it's hard to follow all that's going on in there. There's all these different weights and connections and nodes. And then it comes out and colors the beach ball, the people, the background. What's going on in here is the black and white image goes into this neural network. And before it's ever gone in, the neural network has looked at all these different pictures on the web or wherever it pulls the data from. And it's already itemized them and kind of separated them that we have some that look like beach balls, we have some that look like people, and it programs that so that when the black and white image comes in, it goes, okay, that piece right there resembles this and all these other photos. And the neural network is able to identify that and then color the beach ball with the colors that you see on there. So it gives it a, this is really wonderful because they did a wonderful job coloring this picture. And that's the full setup is where the deep learning example comes in, and they usually center around neural networks. So we looked at a few examples. What's in it for you? First, we're going to talk about...
So that the last example was of the deep learning, where it says that whenever we are putting any black and white image in the model, and that model work on convolutional neural network, and that network is again having a hidden layer in which whenever you're putting any image or any data, it will be go inside through the input layer, and there it will work. We don't know what is going on inside. There is a black box, there is a magic box, and after getting the output of these layers, the finally the information finally the output is provided to the last layer, output layer, and we will get the output. But what is going on inside would totally depend on the machine internal layer algorithm. So this black box, this deep learning algorithm is developed on the basis of reward and the punishment on your information. The output, jo output mil raha hai, usko hum kehte hain, yes, you have did good job, you are correct. If you, aap karte ho na kabhi kabhi, jahan par aap kuch website use karte ho aur aap ye apne reviews bhi dete ho. I am satisfied, 3.4.5. That reward that is useful for that model, useful for that portal to improve. That's why we should give those remarks. And with that remark, the machine will learn and improve itself. So this is the deep learning model. So I am not giving more opportunity to watch the video. You can watch it on YouTube. Let's move to another slide. Okay, wait. Now the definition of AI. AI refers to any technique that enables computers to mimic human intelligence. In short, this is a simple technology. And when you will learn, when you will read the definition of ML and DL, that will be advanced technology. But AI simply refers to any technique that enables computers to mimic human intelligence. Its explanation, it gives the ability to machine to recognize a human's face, to move and manipulate objects. These are examples. To move and human face ko recognize karne ki ability de raha hai, move and manipulate object jaise ATL mein aap model bana rahe hain bachche, to understand the voice commands by humans, voice assistant jaise work kar rahe hain, and also do other tasks. So the sensors ke through jab hum kaam karte hain to wo sensors aapke AI nahi hain, but we can use those technologies with AI, and the AI enabled machines think algorithmically and execute what they have been asked for intelligence. This AI technology is totally based on algorithm. Algorithm will be provided by the programmer, the creator. So that is AI. You can't say this technology as ML. And the next one is ML. This is a subset of AI. What subset of AI means whatever is ML is also AI. जो कुछ भी ML है वो machine learning है, वो artificial intelligence तो होगा ही, but जो भी artificial intelligence है उसको हम ML नहीं कह सकते, because ML is the subset of AI, not AI is the subset of ML. So keep it in mind, ML is the subset of AI, which enables machine to improve a task. It not only enables the machine to mimic human intelligence, but enables machines to improve a task with experience. जैसे जैसे वो डेटा के थ्रू एक्सपीरियंस करेगा, उसके थ्रू मशीन इम्प्रूव होती जा रही है. सो दिस इज ML. एंड द इंटेंशन ऑफ मशीन लर्निंग इज टू एनेबल मशीन टू लर्न बाय देमसेल्फ यूजिंग द प्रोवाइडेड डेटा एंड मेक एक्यूरेट प्रिडिक्शंस एंड डिसीजन. तो क्यों मशीन लर्निंग क्यों सोचा गया, क्योंकि AI के थ्रू जो एल्गोरिदम थे वो, अगर हम उसको फर्दर इम्प्रूवमेंट चाहते हैं तो एल्गोरिदम फिक्स नहीं हो सकते और फार कॉम्प्लिकेटेड होंगे. दैट्स वाई द न्यू टेक्नोलॉजी, द नई इम्प्रूवमेंट इन AI विल कम इन लाइट दैट ML इनेबल द मशीन टू लर्न बाय देमसेल्व्स विद द प्रोवाइडेड डेटा ट्रेनिंग. ओके, एंड देन डीप लर्निंग द थर्ड. This one is the subset of AI, also the subset of ML. When you will make any Venn diagram, then AI is the outer circle, then inside is ML, and then the inner circle will be DL. I missed that diagram. Very important, whenever you are giving differentiation between these, then you should make that diagram, the circle where you can write AI, then inner circle, there you can write ML, and the last one is DL. So DL is the subset of ML. Okay, it is also AI, it is also ML, and it is the subset of ML. The best technology in these three. It enables software to train itself. Ab teenon point ko dhyan do. First, AI enables the machine to mimic human intelligence. And ML enables the machine to improve a task with experience. And DL enables the machine to train itself to perform tasks with vast amount of data. Means, in deep learning, the machine is trained with huge amount of data, which help it in training itself around the data. Such machines are intelligent enough to develop algorithm for themselves. तो यहाँ पर मशीन अपना एल्गोरिदम खुद बना रहा है, और इसकी भी ट्रेनिंग वही है जैसे हमारी पहले हमने ML में की थी कि with vast amount of data, but that algorithm will also improve day by day. जो मशीन में एल्गोरिदम बना है वो भी फिक्स नहीं होता, दैट एल्गोरिदम विल आल्सो इम्प्रूव विद एक्सपीरियंस. सो दिस इज अ टेक्नोलॉजी विच ट्रेन इटसेल्फ टू परफॉर्म टास्क विद वास्ट अमाउंट ऑफ डेटा एंड दैट विल इम्प्रूव विद द एक्सपीरियंस. डीप लर्निंग इज द मोस्ट एडवांस्ड फॉर्म ऑफ आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजेंस आउट ऑफ दीज थ्री. I know that you know this from class 9th, but again reminding you. Then comes machine learning, which is intermediately intelligent. And artificial intelligence covers all the concepts and algorithm which in some way or the other mimic human intelligence. सबसे अच्छी क्या हो गई? That was most advanced form, deep learning. उसके बाद क्या आता है? Machine learning, which is intermediately intelligence. इंटेलिजेंट, और उसके बाद आता है AI, which covers all the concept and algorithm which is some way or other mimic human intelligence. Means AI में वो कोई भी concept algorithm जो human intelligence को mimic कर रहा है वो आ जाते हैं. तो best is DL, then is ML, and then the last one is AI. Okay, now this is another video. You can watch this to understand the differentiation between these three terminologies. Video,
hello everyone, this is Atul from Edureka, and welcome to today's topic of discussion on AI versus machine learning versus deep learning. These are the terms which have confused a lot of people, and if you too are one among them, let me resolve it for you. Well, artificial intelligence is a broader umbrella under which machine learning and deep learning come. You can also see in the
Yes, whenever you are writing the differentiation between these three terminologies, you have to write this first line. What is this? Listen again.
If you two are one among them, let me resolve it for you. Well, artificial intelligence is a broader umbrella under which machine learning and deep learning come. You can also see in the diagram that even deep learning is a subset of machine.
I was talking about the same diagram and also given in your manual.
Machine learning. So you can say that all three of them,
the AI, the machine learning, and deep learning are just the subset of each other. So let's move on and understand how exactly they differ from each other. So let's start with artificial intelligence. The term artificial intelligence was first coined in the year 1956. The concept is pretty old, but it has gained its popularity recently. But why? Well, the reason is, earlier we had very small amount of data. The data we had was not enough to predict the accurate result. But now, there's a tremendous increase in the amount of data. Statistics suggest that by 2020, the accumulated volume of data will increase from 4.4 zettabytes to roughly around 44 zettabytes or 44 trillion GBs of data. Along with such enormous amount of data, now we have more advanced algorithm and high-end computing power and storage that can deal with such large amount of data. As a result, it is expected that 70% of enterprise will implement AI over the next 12 months, which is up from 40% in 2016 and 51% in 2017. Just for your understanding, what is AI? Well, it's nothing but a technique that enables the machine to act like humans by replicating the behavior and nature. With AI, it is possible for machine to learn from the experience. The machines adjust their responses based on new input, thereby performing human-like tasks. Artificial intelligence can be trained to accomplish specific tasks by processing large amount of data and recognizing pattern in them. You can consider that building an artificial intelligence is like building a church. The first church took generations to finish, so most of the workers who were working in it never saw the final outcome. Those working on it took pride in their crafts, building bricks and chiseling stone that was going to be placed into the great structure. So as AI researchers, we should think of ourselves as humble brick makers, whose job is to study how to build components, example parsers, planners, or learning algorithm, or etc. anything, that someday someone and somewhere will integrate into the intelligent systems. Some of the examples of artificial intelligence from our day-to-day life are Apple Siri's, chess playing computer, Tesla's self-driving car, and many more. These examples are based on deep learning and natural language processing. Well, this was about what is AI and how it gains its hype. So moving on ahead, let's discuss about machine learning and see what it is and why it was even introduced. Well, machine learning came into existence in the late 80s and the early 90s. But what were the issues with the people which made the machine learning come into existence? Let us discuss them one by one. In the field of statistics, the problem was how to efficiently train large complex model. In the field of computer science and artificial intelligence, the problem was how to train more robust version of AI system. While in the case of neuroscience, problem faced by the researchers was how to design operational model of the brain. So these were some of the issues which had the largest influence and led to the existence of the machine learning. Now this machine learning shifted its focus from the symbolic approaches it had inherited from the AI and moved towards the methods and model it had borrowed from statistics and probability theory. So let's proceed and see what exactly is machine learning. Well, machine learning is a subset of AI which enables the computer to act and make data-driven decisions to carry out a certain task. These programs or algorithms are designed in a way that they can learn and improve over time when exposed to new data. Let's see an example of machine learning. Let's say you want to create a system which tells the expected weight of a person based on its height. The first thing you do is you collect the data. Let's see, this is how your data looks like. Now each point on the graph represent one data point. To start with, we can draw a simple line to predict the weight based on the height. For example, a simple line W equal H minus 100, where W is weight in kgs and H.
No need to go in these terms, just understand its example.
But recently, its hype has increased and deep learning is getting more attention. This field is a particular kind of machine learning that is inspired by the functionality of our brain cells called neuron, which led to the concept of artificial neural network. It simply takes the data connection between all the artificial neurons and adjusts them according to the data pattern. More neurons are added if the size of the data is large. It automatically features learning at multiple levels of abstraction, thereby allowing a system to learn complex function mapping without depending on any specific algorithm.
So this real-time translation is the example of deep learning in the picture shows here.
You know what? No one actually knows what happens inside a neural network and why it works so well. So currently you can call it as a black box. Let us discuss some of the example of deep learning and understand it in a better way. Let me start with a simple example and explain you how things happen at a conceptual level. Let us try and understand how you recognize a square from other shapes. The first thing you do is you check whether there are four lines associated with the figure or not. Simple concept, right? If yes, we further check if they are connected and closed. Again, if yes, we finally check whether it is perpendicular and all its sides are equal. Correct? If everything fulfills, yes, it is a square. Well, it is nothing but a nested hierarchy of concepts. What we did here, we took a complex task of identifying a square in this case and broke it into simpler tasks. Now this deep learning also does the same thing but at a larger scale. Let's take an example of machine which recognizes the animal. The task of the machine is to recognize whether the given image is of a cat or of a dog. What if we were asked to resolve the same issue using the concept of machine learning? What we would do? First, we would define the features such as check whether the animal has whiskers or not, or check if the animal has pointed ears or not, or whether its tail is straight or curved. In short, we will define the facial features and let the system identify which features are more important in classifying a particular animal. Now, when it comes to deep learning, it takes this to one step ahead. Deep learning automatically finds out the features which are most important for classification, compared to machine learning, where we had to manually give out that features. By now, I guess you have understood that AI is the bigger picture and machine learning and deep learning are its subpart. So let's move on and focus our discussion on machine learning and deep learning. The easiest way to understand the difference between the machine learning and deep learning is to know that deep learning is machine learning. More specifically, it is the next evolution of machine learning. Let's take few important parameters and compare machine learning with deep learning. So starting with data dependencies. The most important difference between deep learning and machine learning is its performance as the volume of the data gets increased. From the below graph, you can see that when the size of the data is small, deep learning algorithm doesn't perform that well. But why? Well, this is because deep learning algorithm needs a large amount.
Yes, deep learning algorithm work on vast amount of data. This is also one point of differentiation between ML and DL. When we are working with ML, we are giving them training and after the training, it is working. But in deep learning, we are giving the far more vast amount of data. So this is one difference between
amount of data to understand it perfectly. On the other hand, the machine learning algorithm can easily work with smaller data set. Fine. Next comes the hardware dependencies. Deep learning algorithms are heavily dependent on high-end machines, while the machine learning algorithm can work on low-end machines as well. This is because the requirement of deep learning algorithm include GPUs, which is an integral part of its working. The deep learning algorithm requires GPUs as they do a large amount of matrix multiplication operations, and these operations can only be efficiently optimized using a GPU as it is built for this purpose only. Our third parameter will be feature engineering. Well, feature engineering is a process of putting the domain knowledge to reduce the complexity of the data and make patterns more visible to learning algorithms. This process is difficult and expensive in terms of time and expertise. In case of machine learning, most of the features are needed to be identified by an expert and then
I'm stopping it. You can watch the video. I will share the link to you. Means image recognition, if we are taking an example of image recognition like you have done with machine learning with kids, in there we are giving two objects and train the machine and after that it will predict what is showing, what you are showing on the camera. That is the example of ML. And if we are saying that it is deep learning model, in deep learning model, it is not necessary that you will give two set of data. First you will say this is cat, this is dog, then the machine will categorize the input data, what it is it. Model machine need to categorize or classify the data itself. Okay, you are giving this one is cat, this one dog, it is with ML, but in deep learning you will not say anything what is cat and what is dog. Machine will clustering or classifying it those images itself, and after that it will give the result on your input its own. So this is the basic difference between deep learning. And for that deep learning, the AI model will use the feature engineering technique. वो आपको अभी नहीं करना, वो आगे जब पढ़ोगे तब समझ में आएगा. Images को हम lower रिजोल्यूशन पे लाते हैं, उनकी आपका जो डायमेंशन है वो कम करते हैं. आफ्टर दैट द लेयर्स विल कैन वर्क ऑन दैट डेटा. सो दिस डीप नॉलेज आपको अभी नहीं चाहिए, आप आगे चैप्टर में जब पढ़ोगे तो आपको क्लियर हो जाएगा. सो आई एम स्टॉपिंग दिस वीडियो हियर एंड यू कैन वॉच द वीडियो इफ यू वॉन्ट टू नो मोर. ओके, सो आई एम स्टॉपिंग दिस बिकॉज द नेक्स्ट सेक्शन CS, CV एंड दिस NLP is not coming in UT1, so you complete your syllabus till that part and get ready for the unit test. All question will be MCQ. Understand the concept well. No need to worry about, and yes, no need to cheat, because with cheating you will waste your time. If you will think little bit, you can give the answer. So all the best for your UTs.